The sun. It provides warmth and light to everybody on the planet, but could also be the source of significant problems in our increasingly wired world. When they're strong enough, solar eruptions like these have the capability of damaging electronics and causing electricity and communications outages on Earth. So to better understand what's going on in the sun, NASA on Thursday evening launched a new solar telescope. IRIS, the Interface Region Imaging Spectrograph, was put into orbit by a rocket dropped from an aircraft above the Pacific Ocean. It promises to provide the most detailed view yet of the sun's lower atmosphere. This region exhibits an unusual effect. Temperatures are believed to be around 6,000 Kelvin near the sun's surface and heat up to around 1,000,000 Kelvin at the top of the region. That's different to our conventional experience with heat sources, where temperatures rise as the source is approached. It's a mystery for scientists.
The instruments that look at this region in the past have had about 20 times poorer resolution spatially and about 20 times poorer resolution spectrally. And spectrally allows us to measure temperatures, velocities, pressures. So it's important to have spectroscopic information. But basically, we've been looking at things that happen so fast that data taken as slowly as previous instruments have done really hasn't given us any information.
Data from the spacecraft will be received and analyzed here at NASA's Ames Research Center in Mountain View, in the heart of Silicon Valley. Ames is home to Palladius, currently the 19th most powerful supercomputer on the planet.
There's not been a push to look at this region because the atomic physics in this region is very, very, very complicated.
As ever more sensitive electronics are used around the world, study of the effects of the sun on Earth are becoming increasingly pressing. A recent study by Lloyd's of London said between 20 and 40 million people in the US are at risk of being without power for between 2 weeks and 2 years should a violent solar storm hit. The country is particularly at risk because of its aging power grid.
We believe that some, maybe a lot of power outages, actually have a lot to do with solar activity. So the better we can understand the physics going on, the better we can understand that activity, the better that we could potentially predict and mitigate some of these problems.
At NASA's Ames Research Center in Mountain View, this is Martin Williams, IDG News Service.